सो वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर तुंगल ऑनलाइन क्लासेस. वी आर डिस्कसिंग द चैप्टर रे ऑप्टिक्स. इन दिस रे ऑप्टिक्स एस्टरडे वी कंप्लीटेड. सो रिफ्रैक्शन इट इज स्फेरिकल सरफेस, दैट इज म्यू टू बाई वी माइनस म्यू वन बाई यू इज इक्वल टू म्यू टू माइनस म्यू वन डिवाइड बाई आर. सो टूडे विल सी रिगार्डिंग द लेंसेस, रिफ्रैक्शन बाई द लेंसेस. सो वॉट इज लेंस? Lens means what? Today topic is very very important. So today we'll discuss one important derivation that is for 5 marks. So that is of lens maker's formula. Before deriving that lens maker's formula, let me tell you what is a lens. So lens as an optical medium, optical transparent medium, optical transparent medium. Medium bounded by two refracting surfaces, two refracting surfaces, so in which so One at least spherical. So this is the definition for the lens. A lens is an optical medium bounded by two refracting surfaces. Out of these two refracting surfaces, one will be at least spherical. So that is called as a lens. So actually, what are the types of lens? We will come across. So two types. One is of convex lens and other is of concave lens. Concave lens. So what is the meaning of convex lens? Convex lens. A lens which is so thicker at the middle, and thinner at the edges. So convex lens. A lens, it is an optical medium bounded by two refracting surfaces. A lens which is so thicker at the middle and thinner at the edges is called as convex lens. Here what I written, this is called as biconvex lens, which has two refracting surfaces which are both are convex, both are spherical. This is called as biconvex lens. A convex lens is also called as converging lens or positive lens. Similarly, so this is called as plano-convex lens. Plano-convex lens. One side plane and one side convex. So plano-convex lens. And one more will be there, that is called as so concave-concave lens. That we'll see next term. So basically, the convex lens means what? A lens. So convex lens, which one is called as convex lens? A lens which is so thicker at the middle and thinner at the edges. Similarly, so what is the meaning of concave lens? Biconvex, by plano convex I written. I will show you convex or concave lens and concave or convex lens later. What is the meaning of concave lens? A lens which is so that is reverse. Now last time we consider so lens which is thicker at the middle, thinner at the edges, whereas for concave lens which is so thinner at the middle and thicker at the edges, such a lens is called as concave lens. Even this what I written, that is called as biconcave lens. This name is biconcave lens. So if I consider this, this is called as plano concave lens. It has two refracting surfaces, and one will be spherical. So are you getting Aram? What is lens and what is convex lens and what is concave lens? And this concave lens is also called as a diverging lens. Why it is called as a diverging lens, we'll come to know. Convex lens is called as converging lens. Even convex lens can also call as positive lens. And concave lens is also called as negative lens. After writing the lens, again we will see some terminology which we will use. So for these lenses, for this lens, what is the basic terminology we will come across? So first we'll consider what is principal axis. Principal axis, optic center, then radius of curvature or principal focus. What is principal axis? Either it may be a convex lens or concave lens. So what is the meaning of principal axis? If I consider a biconvex lens, we'll have two spherical surfaces. The two spherical surface are the two parts of a sphere. This is one part of the sphere, this is also part of a sphere. For this center of curvature will be there, for this center of curvature will be there. If I draw a line passing through center of curvatures of the two spherical surfaces, that line is called as principal axis. What is the principal axis of a lens? The principal axis of a lens is the line passing through center of curvatures of two spherical surfaces. When I consider one spherical surface, what are the definitions I told to you? Polo, center of curvature, everything will be seen. So this is the pole for one spherical surface and this is the pole for second spherical surface. So this is called as principal axis. For this convex lens, so principal axis definition okay na? What is the meaning of radius of curvature? Since it has two spherical surfaces, so a lens will have two radius of curvatures. So radius of curvature of one spherical surface, this is one, this is two. First radius of curvature value given by R1, second value given by R2, that I will tell you. So what is principal axis, understood now? Principal axis is the line passing through center of curvatures of two spherical surfaces. After coming to know this, the second definition is what is optical center or optic center. Generally we know for a spherical surface we will measure the distances from the pole only na. But if there are two spherical surfaces are there, two poles will be there. So from which pole we need to measure the distance? In case of these lenses, we will measure the distance from the optic center. What is meaning of optic center? So optic center will always lies on the principal axis, which is given by C. For example, a light ray was incident here. Now light ray will be refracted like this. Okay na? So after refraction, now light ray will bend like this. What is the meaning of optic center? Optic center means what? So optic center means what? Now if this refraction not there, then light ray will travel in a straight line. See, whenever a light ray passing through, if the refracted ray, what is the meaning of optic center? Optic center is the point inside the lens on the principal axis. If any refracted ray passing through this optic center, the emergent ray will be parallel to incident ray. That point is called as optic center. Definition is important. So all the distances in case of lenses will be measured from this optic center only. Are you getting around? Optic center is the point inside the lens on the principal axis. If any light ray passing through this optic center, so such a way that the refracted ray or the emergent ray parallel to incident ray, that point name is called as optic center. So in case of a thin lens, what is the meaning of thin lens whose thickness is very small? Whenever I consider a thin lens, any light ray passing through optic center will comes out without any deviation. Without any deviation. Deviation will be there, that will be very small, which can be neglected. That's why any light ray passing through optic center will comes out without any deviation. You can define the optic center anyone, either this or this. So I think, so for the thin lens, optic center is the point. If any light ray passing through this optic center will comes out without any deviation, that is the definition of optic center. So optic center C. Now if I call this is P1, this is P2 and this is P1, and here is of center of curvature c1 and center of curvature c2. So now what I can able to write is cp1 by cp2. What is the distance of optic center from the so two poles? This is p1 and p2. cp1 by cp2 is exactly equal to c1 p1 divided by c2 p2, which is equal to r1 by r2. What does it mean? Optic center will divide, so ratio of the radius of curvatures equally. What is cp1 by cp2 is exactly equal to r1 by r2. What is r1 and r2? Radius of curvatures. R1 and R2 are the radius of curvature. So for these lenses, there are two spherical surfaces are there. That's why two radius of curvatures will be there. The C1 P1 value will be equal to R1 and C2 P2 value will be equal to R2. So this is the definition of optic center. After coming to know optic center, what is the meaning of principal focus? Principal focus. Same wrong. So principal focus for mirror we define. For a spherical mirror, principal focus is the point at which the light rays which are incident parallel to principal axis after reflection converges or appear to be diverge. Similarly, what is the principal focus? If the light rays are incident parallel to principal axis. So generally after refraction the light rays will converge at a point in case of converging lens. If I consider a diverging lens, this is the principal axis, the light rays are incident here, so light rays will be refracted like this. The two refracted rays will never meet. The two refracted rays are appear to be diverging from a point. That point only called as principal focus. So what is principal focus? Principal focus is the point, so at which whenever the light rays, if they are incident parallel to the principal axis after refraction, converges. In case of which lens? Convex lens. Or they appear to be diverge. In case of which lens? In case of concave lens. That point only called as principal focus. The principal focus is the point whenever the light rays which are incident, so which are incident parallel to principal axis after refraction converges or appear to be diverge. That point called as principal focus. A convex lens having real principal focus, whereas a concave lens having virtual principal focus. Virtual principal focus. And one more important point, it is not compulsory always the light rays should come from the left side. Whenever the light rays are incident parallel to principal axis from the right side, they will focus, they will converge, so on the left side. That's why a lens will have two principal focus will be there. So one will be of left side, one will be of right side. That you have to remember. After coming to know, so next terminology, what is the meaning of focal length? Focal length means what? Already we know, in case of mirror, focal length is the distance between principal focus and pole. Whereas in case of these lenses, so what is the focal length? If I consider the convex lens, so this is the center of curvature or optic center. Light rays are incident parallel to principal axis. After refraction, light rays are converging at a point F. Then the distance between the optic center and principal focus is called as the focal length. The focal length of a lens is the distance. If I consider in case of the concave mirror, the concave lens, now the light rays are incident parallel to principal axis, light rays are refracted like this. The two light rays are appear to be coming from a point. This is called as principal focus. Here it will be there of center of curvature. This distance between, so not center of curvature, it is called as optic center. The distance between the optic center and the principal focus, that distance is called as so focal length. Generally a convex lens will have, now you see sign convention for F, I want to measure CF. दिस डिस्टेंस इज मेजर्ड फ्रॉम द ऑल द डिस्टेंसेज शुड मेजर्ड फ्रॉम वेयर सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर ओनली सॉरी ऑप्टिक सेंटर ओनली सो दैट्स वाई दो द डिस्टेंसेज हियर ऑल्सो द साइन कन्वेंशन फॉलो सेम डिस्टेंसेज विच आर मेजर्ड इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इंसिडेंट रे आर पॉजिटिव विच आर मेजर्ड अपोजिट टू इंसिडेंट रे आर नेगेटिव विच आर एबो द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस हाइट्स आर पॉजिटिव बिलो द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस हाइट्स आर नेगेटिव सो सी एफ वैल्यू विल बी इक्वल टू प्लस एफ वेर एज हियर सी टू एफ दैट इज इन द डायरेक्शन अपोजिट टू इंसिडेंट रे सो सी एफ वैल्यू विल बी माइनस वॉट डज इट मीन सो कॉन्वेक्स लेंस विल हैव पॉजिटिव फोकल लेंथ एंड कॉन्केव लेंस विल हैव सो नेगेटिव फोकल लेंथ A convex lens will have real principal focus and concave lens will have virtual principal focus. Are you getting that? So this is regarding the principal focus and the focal length. By this knowledge, now we will derive one important derivation based on the lenses, that is the lens maker's formula. So very, very, very important derivation for us, for subjective point of view. Even many times given question this one so what is the lens maker's formula so derive lens maker's formula lens makers formula or show that this question can be also asked show that so 1 by f is equal to mu minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2 this is lens makers formula What is the lens maker's formula? Lens maker's formula is a relation between so focal length, refractive index, and radius of curvatures. The relation between the focal length, refractive index, and radius of curvatures. That relation is called as lens maker's formula. So by using this lens maker's formula we can design the lens of desired focal length how much focal length we want that focal length of required length we can make it but remember for making this lens maker's formula we will apply the sign convention what is the sign convention I written same ram in order to derive this relation all the distances measured from the optic center along the principal axis distances measured from optic center along the principal axis first condition the second condition is distances measured in the direction of incident ray already these rules you know in the direction of incident ray are taken as positive incident ray are taken as positive and opposite to incident ray or otherwise means which are opposite to incident ray taken as negative and similarly the third rule is heights measure above the principal axis taken as positive and below the principal axis are taken as negative negative. So these are the sign convention we will use for deriving this Lensmaker's formula. If the derivation they given means it is not compulsory to write this sign convention, but this sign convention you should know. After writing this sign convention, now for deriving this derivation we will make some assumptions. We cannot design the any lens by using this Lensmaker's formula. We'll make some assumptions for deriving this Lensmaker's formula. So what are that assumptions? Let us check it. Assumptions are made, and these assumptions better if you write in examination also. What are the assumptions which are required to derive the Lensmaker's formula? The first one is aperture of the lens. Aperture of the lens is small. What is the meaning of aperture? I told you now. So generally, if area, the area which can be exposed to the light, if the diameter or area of this lens is more number of light rays will incident, then we'll get a image brightness will be of more. If I consider area less, so brightness of the image is less. The intensity directly proportional to square of the aperture. But for deriving this derivation, we will make assumption that the aperture of the lens is very small. Understood, Ara? The second assumption we will make is object is of point size. Object is point size placed on the principal axis. Compulsory, object is of point size placed on the principal axis. This is one condition. And the third condition will make angle of incidence I and angle of refraction R are very small. When this angle of incidence and angle of refraction are small, the light rays are paraxial rays. For deriving this derivation, we'll make so light rays are paraxial rays. And one more, the last condition will make, so lens is a thin lens. Which lens? Thin lens. So thin lens whose thickness is very very smaller. Lensmaker's formula is useful only for so designing or making only thin lens, not for all lenses. This condition is must and should you have to remember. It is applicable only for thin lenses. So these are the assumptions we will make for deriving this Lensmaker's formula. With this sign convention and with these assumptions, now we will derive a Lensmaker's formula. So derivation is very 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 important derivation. Many times given question for 5 marks. They won't ask you maximum what is Lensmaker's formula. Okay, Nara? Now let us consider. So here I am deriving the Lensmaker's formula for convex lens and real image and real object and real image. Again here also cases will be there. I can consider the convex lens, real image and real object. I can consider the convex lens, real object and virtual image. I can consider the concave lens, real object and virtual image. So I am considering for convex lens, what is the case I am considering? For convex lens, real object and real image. So object is real and image also real. Real object and real image. Okay, Nara? Now let us see. So consider one double convex lens. This double convex lens, let me call the name A. This one is P1, B, and A, this is P2 and B. This double convex lens of refractive index mu, it is placed in air. So air of refractive index, this is 1. A double convex lens of refractive index mu is placed in air or vacuum of refractive index 1. Okay, Nara? For this double convex lens, so this center of curvature is C. Now let us consider object. Object already we made assumption, point object. So placed on the principal axis. Object, a point object placed on the principal axis at a distance of u. At a distance of u from the optic center. When image will form, when light rays incident on the lens after refraction, if they converge or appear to be diverge, I'll get an image. Now let us consider one of the light ray which incident along the principal axis. It comes out without any deviation. Without any deviation, it will comes out. Let me consider another light ray was incident here. Another light ray was incident there. Okay, na? So this light ray will undergo refraction two times. First time the light ray will bend. One time it will bend. Second time also the light ray will bend. And finally, the two refracted rays are there. The two refracted rays are converging at a point I. So where I is the image whose distance from the optic center is V. Are you getting around? How many times the light ray undergone refraction? Two times. So this mirror will have two spherical surface. One is A P1B, other A P2B. It undergone the refraction at A P1B one time and A P2B two times. So in this notation I will write. What is the notation here is, so in this diagram ra, what is the value of OC, object distance OC? So that is object distance is U, image distance is V. Okay na ra? This whole diagram cleared ra? Finally, the image is formed at I. The image formation due to the refraction at AP1B and AP2B. This image formation can be splitted into two parts. First you have to write the diagram right corner and you should explain regarding the diagram. Consider a double convex lens of with two refracting surface AP1B and AP2B. This AP1B, the radius of curvature R1 is the radius of curvature of the spherical surface AP1B, and R2 is the radius of curvature of the spherical surface AP2B. Clear, Dara? R1 and R2 are the radius of curvatures. Now, to derive this, first I am considering the derivation part. And this derivation after writing theory part. So, in the absence of this image formation splitting into two parts, in the absence of AP2B, in this derivation first I will consider, so refraction at AP1B. Only if I consider refraction at AP1B, so if I consider AP2B not there, in the absence of AP2B, so what happened? AP1B is there now. Here actually, in the absence of AP2B, now I consider only AP1B. This diagram is over. Now one more diagram. This is of which one? AP1B. And here is there my object O. So then what happened? The light ray incident one ray and another ray. Actually, in the absence of which one? AP2B, light ray will not bend two times. Light will bend only one time. So light will travel straight line. Image will be formed at I dash. This I dash at a distance of V dash. Just think that, very important. If I not consider AP2B, image will not be there at I. Light ray will bend only one time. So second time it will not bend. It will go in a straight line and image formed at I dash. So in the absence of AP2B, AP1B form the image at where? It forming the image at I dash. So actually this is a convex lens. I consider it as thin lens. When I consider the thin lens, the distance measured from the optic center or pole nearly same. When I dealing with one spherical surface, I want to measure the distance from the pole only. For this, the spherical surface APPB, AP1B, the distance of the object is U and distance of the image, can I call it as V dash? Now this AP1B dividing the medium into two parts. It is a refracting surface now. So this medium refractive index, can I call mu1 air? So mu1 value 1. And this medium refractive index is mu2. So mu2 value will be equal to mu. Now can I apply the refraction at a spherical surface formula? According to that formula, so refractive index of the image space mu by distance of the image minus refractive index of the object space, can I call mu 2 by v dash minus mu 1 by u, will be equal to refractive index of the image space minus refractive index of the object space by what is the radius of curvature r1. Are you getting a how I written this? But here mu 2 value is mu by v dash, mu 1 value is 1. Better I will call this one mu 1 only, I will call this refractive index is mu 1 and this is my rarer medium. Better na, I will call it as mu 1, this is mu 2. Then what I will get here, what is the answer I am getting? So mu 2 by v dash minus mu 1 by u is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by r. Can I write a? So can I call it as equation 1 na? Can I call this one as equation 1? So this is only due to refraction at where APB, the refraction at AP1B, I got this equation. Mu 2 by V dash minus mu 1 by U is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by R1. Right or wrong? Now, till now understood? This is very easy to understand, but the second part is important. So equation 1 you keep in mind, I don't have the space, that's what I am rubbing. Now the second one is refraction at AP2B. AP2B in the absence of AP1B. The second time what should I consider? I should consider the spherical surface AP2B. Now what happened actually, both together forming the image at I. First when I consider AP1B, AP1B in the absence of AP2B alone forming the image at I dash. But actually, so now first one duty is over, second one came for shift. Now they divide the work into two shift. So half shift work is completed by AP1B. The remaining half shift work will be completed by AP2B. When AP2B came, for this AP2B, this I1 dash or I dash, which is at a distance of V dash, will act like a virtual object. For this AP2B, object will not be there. Already, the object light rays are incident on AP1B, it formed the image at I dash. This I dash act like a virtual object, virtual object. So after refraction, whose real image formed at where I only. The distance of the image given by what V, this should be cleared. Are you getting a? So this spherical refracting surface AP2B dividing the medium into two parts, this side part will become mu 2 and this side part will become mu 1. Only one thing you have to do. So when AP2B came to the shifter, the half work of the shift completed by AP1B, it did its duty, half duty, it made the image at I dash. But final image should be formed at I. In order to form the I dash will act like a virtual object for AP2B, whose real image formed at I. Are you getting a? Now once again, we need to write the mirror, that refraction formula. What is that refraction formula? The refractive index of the image space by distance of the image. What is the image here? I. It is forming in which medium? Mu 1. So mu 1 divided by which one? V. Mu 1 divided by V. What is the equation now? Last one I got. When I consider AP1B, what is the equation I got? I will write, written already. So mu 1 by V. Okay, Nara? So minus, what is the image object distance here? V dash is equal to image refractive index mu 1, object refractive index mu 2. Correct, Ara? Object was there of this side. And here, an important point, Ara. What is the refractive index of the object space? Actually, here I dash act like an object, but actually object is not there here. Object is there of this side only. So that's why this side refractive index is of mu 2. Compulsory, no doubt. Everyone should get the doubt here itself. Sir, why you written here mu 2? Here actually I dash is not there. It act like a virtual object. It will not be there. It appear to be as there. Actually object is there this side only, na? So because of AP2B, this part refractive index will become mu 2. But real distance value V dash, so mu 2 by V dash. is equal to image refractive index mu 1 minus object refractive index mu 2 by radius of curvature r 2. So this is equation 2. Are you getting ara? This point should be cleared. Only here remaining all cleared. Image refractive index mu 1, but the object will be of this side. When I consider AP to be dividing the medium into two parts, so this part will become mu 2, that part will become mu 1. So that's why mu 2 by v dash is equal to mu 1 minus mu 2 by r 2. Are you getting a mu 1 minus mu 2 divided by r 2? Now I got some mu 1 value and mu 2 value. Compulsory, if any doubt is there regarding the second equation, so you can ask in group also. First you have to go through, 100% you will get the doubt. What is equation 1 now I got equation 1, so mu 2 by v minus mu 1, image distance is v dash now, mu 2 by v dash minus mu 1 by u is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 by r 1. This one we got equation 1, now I got equation 2, so mu 1 by v minus mu 2 by v dash is equal to mu 1 minus mu 2 by r 1 or r 2. Can I write this as, so which is minus of mu 2 minus mu 1 by r 2? Can I put a minus? Can I write a, if I take minus common here, what I will get? Minus of mu 2 minus mu 1 by r 2. Can I call equation 2 a? I made minus common, then mu 2 minus mu 1 by r 2. Now I got equation 1 and 2. Can I add these two equations? By adding these two equations, what I will get? 1 plus 2. 1 plus 2 if I add. So mu 2 by v dash, mu 2 by v dash cancel. What I will get? Mu 1 by v minus mu 1 by u is equal to, I can take the common of mu 2 minus mu 1 into, so 1 by r 1 minus 1 by r 2. Clear? So if I take mu 1 also common, which is 1 by v 1, 1 by v minus 1 by u is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 into 1 by r 1 minus 1 by r 2. Right, Ara? So from this, I will rub this diagram here. I will write the remaining part. So everyone getting very important derivation. Okay, Ara? So what is that case is, now if I write it as 1 by v minus 1 by u is equal to, can I send that mu 1 that side? I will get mu 2 minus mu 1 by mu 1 into 1 by r 1 minus 1 by r 2. Right, Ara? So which can be written as 1 by v minus 1 by u, this is mu 2 by mu 1 minus 1 into 1 by r 1 minus 1 by r 2. Can I rub this? So now, if so object is placed at infinite, u value infinite, so what will get the answer of v? V will be equal to f. This you know, same rule like mirror, in convex concave mirror, when our object is there at infinite, image will be formed at a principal focus f. If u value infinity, always remember, whenever object is there at infinite, if any light rays are incident parallel to principal axis, whenever object is there at infinite, light rays will become parallel to the principal axis. After refraction, the light rays will converge at principal focus, so image distance will become f. Whenever object is there at infinite, image distance will become, so f. If u value infinity, v value will become f. Then what I will get? 1 by f minus 1 by infinity will be equal to this mu 2 1, can I write? Mu 2 1 minus 1 into 1 by r 1 minus 1 by r 2. So 1 by infinity value will be 0, which is 1 by f minus 0. This is equal to relative refractive index now. Mu 2 1 minus 1 into 1 by r 1 minus 1 by r 2. Right, Ara? So which can be finally written as 1 by f is equal to mu 2 1 minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. This is our required lens maker's formula. If mu 1 value equal to 1, that is A, then 1 by F value will become this mu 2 1, relative refractive index will become absolute refractive index. If mu 2 is equal to 1, mu 1 is equal to 1, mu 2 is equal to mu, I will get the answer mu minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. So this is our required lens maker's formula. Understood, Ara? So for deriving this lens maker's formula, compulsory we need to use refraction at a spherical surface formula. By using that refraction at a spherical surface, we can derive this lens maker's formula. So lens maker's formula gives us the relation between focal length, refractive index and radius of curvature. So according to this formula, 1 by f is equal to mu minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. Once you go through this lens maker's formula, derivation I cannot give PPT. PPT derivation I cannot PowerPoint presentation, I don't have. So that's why you have to write from the class notes only. Derivation diagram clearly explained. But today, lens maker's formula is very, very important derivation, many times given for examination point of view. Okay, Nara? So, next class will continue, next topic. Thank you.